My name is Janet Montgomery. I'm an archaeological scientist at the University of Durham. My job involves doing scientific methods, chemical techniques, where I take tiny, tiny samples from human skeletons, from animal skeletons, to analyse them and find out more information about people in the past. If you're about 10 years old, you'll have some of your teeth visible in your mouth, but some of them will still be in your jaw, and they are recording as they grow all sorts of information. We can take tiny, tiny samples. So I take a tooth and I take a very small sample from it, and then we take that into the laboratory and we dissolve it up and we put it into a machine that measures what's in the tooth. So one of the elements that we look at is oxygen in the water that you drink, and that oxygen in that water then gets deposited in your teeth. We have oxygen isotope maps for the whole world. So depending how far away from the equator coast, and if you're on the top of the mountain or in a valley, the oxygen isotope ratios in the rain that fall change. So we can use those to give us an indication of the temperature, the distance from the sea, the distance from the equator, and also the altitude at which you were living. Strontium, on the other hand, is a heavy metal that gets deposited in your teeth. The strontium comes out of those rocks into the soils and then into the plants that are grown on the soils and into the animals and the humans that eat the plants. We can then look at the strontium isotope ratio result. If you get a very low value, it can only be basalt. Some numbers are not quite as specific because there might be several different types of rock that can give you that actual result. We looked at three individuals from White Hawk. Everything about the man was consistent with him growing up in the Brighton area, but the two women, they either came together or there was a tradition of women moving into the Brighton area from somewhere else. The isotope data suggests that it was somewhere of a similar climate, but the geology was very different. They'd grown up in a region of what we call sedimentary rocks, such as sandstones. We can't actually pin down where that is, but it's not in the southeast of England. Before we had these techniques, the idea in archaeology at the time was that people didn't move around a lot. What we're finding now with these methods is that was not the case. In all time periods, lots of people moved around during their lifetime. But there's so much more that we can do. There's a lot more we don't understand about the environmental variation and how we can interpret the data. So hopefully in the future, we'll be able to tell us a lot more about people in the past.